The ratio is a question between two numbers or measurement. The ratio is a question between two numbers or measurement. A ratio is usually denoted by using a colon. Okay, a ratio is usually denoted by using a colon. Now what is colon? See, these dots we are using to show the ratio. This is called the colon. Okay, now see here. Following points about ratio must be kept in mind. See, you have to keep in mind these points. Okay. See, I have written on the board. I will explain this. Ratio has no unit. Okay. Ratio has no unit, as it indicates number of times a quantity is bigger or smaller than other. Quantity is bigger or smaller than other. It indicates. Okay. Then the ratio A is to B. Ratio A is to B, see this is A is to B, can also be expressed as a fraction. This ratio can be expressed as a fraction A upon B, as a fraction A upon B. See, the ratio A is to B can also be expressed as a fraction A upon B. Okay. So now A is called the antecedent. See, this A is called the antecedent. And B is called the consequent. A is called the antecedent and B is called the consequent. Okay. Now next point. Third point. Since a ratio is quotient of two numbers. Ratio is quotient of two numbers. I have explained you what is ratio. Ratio is quotient of two numbers. Divided in a definite order. Divided in definite order. Care must be taken to write each ratio in its intended order. Means what it is? If ratio is given 3:4. If ratio is given 3:4, then we should write 3:4 only. See, 3:4 only. See, since a ratio is the quotient of two numbers. Ratio is the quotient of two numbers. Divided in definite order. It is divided in definite order. Care must be taken to write each ratio in its intended order. Means if it is given 3:4, we should write 3:4 only. If it is given 1:3, we should write 1:3 only. Okay, means it should be written in the given order. Okay. Now next point, to find the ratio of two quantities. What it is given? To find the ratio of two quantities, both the quantities must be expressed in the same unit. Now see here, I will write. Here there is no place to explain you this example. See, fourth point. To find the ratio of two quantities, we have to find the ratio of two quantities. Both the quantities must be expressed in the same unit. Suppose now we have to find the ratio of 1 meter is to 20 centimeter. Okay. What it is given? To find the ratio of two quantities, both the quantities must be expressed in the same unit. Now we are given two quantities. Okay. To find the ratio of two quantities, both the quantities must be expressed in the same unit. Both the quantities must be expressed in the same unit. Now if you will see, if you will observe, these both are different unit. Here it is given in meter and this is given in the centimeter. So we should express this in the same unit. So what we will do? Meter we will convert into centimeter. Okay, it should be expressed in the same unit. What it is given? It must be expressed in the same unit. Unit must be the same. If this is given in meter and this is given in the centimeter, see your units are different. So we should make it same unit. Okay. So now same unit means now meter we will convert into centimeter. So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay. So meter we convert into centimeter. So we got both in same unit. 100 centimeter is to 20 centimeter. Now we will find the ratio. 1 meter is to 20 centimeter. Now 1 meter means what? see, we convert 1 meter into 100 centimeter. So we have to find the ratio 100 is to 20. 100 is to 20. So what is after that? It is given ratio is expressed in the simplest form. Now this is given ratio and we have to express the ratio in the simplest form. See, ratio is 100 is to 20. So let's this write in the form of fraction. So we can write in the simplest form. Ratio is expressed in the simplest form. So what is simplest form? See, upper 0, downside 0 get cancel. Now 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10. So what is the ratio we got? 5 is to 1. What ratio? Ratio is expressed in the simplest form. 5 is to 1 we got. See, 5 upon 1 we got. What we got here? 5 upon 1. Ratio is expressed in the simplest form. So we find this in the simplest form. So what we got? 5 is to 1. So what answer we got? 5 upon 1 means 5 is to 1. So what we got? 5 is to 1. Okay. Let's learn now comparison of ratio. Example C. Compare 5 is to 12 and 7 is to 8. Now what is mean by comparison of ratio? Now you know to compare the fraction. You have already learned to compare the fraction. Same way we have to compare the ratio. Okay, now example, compare 5 is to 12 and 7 is to 8. Now first this ratio we will write in the form of fraction. See, 5 is to 12 means 5 upon 12. 5 upon 12. And 7 is to 8 means 7 upon 8. Now we have to compare this. Okay, now we have written this ratio in the form of fraction and we know how to compare the fraction. Okay, so for that what we are doing, see, we check first denominator. If denominators are same, then we compare its numerator. Okay, if denominators are same, we compare its numerator. But now if you will see, your denominators are also not same and numerators are also not same. So what we have to do, we have to make the denominator same. So how to make the denominator same? By finding LCM. So let's find the LCM. Okay, LCM of 12 and 8. Okay, LCM of 12 and 8. So write here LCM of 12 and 8. What is the LCM of 12 and 8? See, we have to make the denominator same. Now, so let's find the LCM of 12 and 8. Now LCM of, now which is greater denominator? 12. Let's see. 12 is there in 8 table? No. Next multiple of 12? 24. 24 is there in 8 table? Yes. So what is the LCM? LCM is 24. LCM of 12 and 8 is 24. Okay. If you don't know to find the LCM this way, you can find by this way, 12 and 8. Now find the factors for this. 2 6s are 12, 2 4s are 8. Then again we divide by 2. 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. Now what is the LCM? 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 2s are 24. Okay, see, here we got prime numbers. Now, so till here only we have to find the factors. Okay, or you can write this way also. 2, 2 is divisible by 2. So write here 3 as it is. 2 1s are 2. 3 is divisible by 3, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 12 2s are 24. So what is the LCM? LCM we got 24. Okay, so now LCM we got 24 means which denominator we have to make? 24. LCM we got 24 means we have to make the denominator 24. Now let's write this fraction. 5 upon 12. 12 what's are 24? We have to make the denominator 24. Yes, denominator we have to make 24. So 12 words are 24. 12 twos are 24. So let's multiply by 2 for the numerator also. Okay, and now what we have to compare? We are going to compare. So right here box. Okay, now next number 7 upon 8. 8 words are 24. 8 threes are 24. 8 3s are 24. So we are multiplying by 3 for the denominator. With the same number we have to multiply for the numerator. Okay. So now 5 2s are 10. 12 2s are 24. Okay. Write your box. 7 3s are 20. say we got the denominators equal, we got denominator. Now compare its numerator, which is greater, 10 or 21? 21 is the greater. So which ratio is greater? Comparison of ratio, 5 is to 12 and 7 is to 18 is 5 is to 12 and so in the right box 7 is to 8. In this both the ratio which is greater, this is greater. See, 7 is to 8. 7 is to 8 is greater. Okay. Let's now practice 8.1 question number 1. In an excursion, there are 76 students and 4 teachers. How many number of students? 76 students and 4 teachers. See, I have underlined here. What is the ratio of number of teachers to the number of students? What it is asked? What is the ratio of number of students? What it is asked? Ratio of number of teachers to the number of students. So what we have to find? Required ratio. What is equal to, what it is asked, what is the ratio of number of teachers? Okay, number of teachers to the, means it's to the number of students. Number of students. Okay. What we have to find, what is the ratio of number of teachers? Number of teachers is to number of students. We have to find the ratio. Okay. So, number of teachers. How many number of teachers are there? 4. See, 4. And number of students? 76. Okay. Let's find the ratio. So, while finding the ratio, what we have to do after this? We have to write this ratio in simplest form. Okay, so write the simplest form for this. See, both the numbers are divisible by 2. See, as x1's place is 4 and x1's place is 6. So, both the numbers are divisible by 2. So, write here 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6, 2 8's are 16. So, what we got? 2 upon 38. Now, still we can do the lowest term. Yes, 2 1's are 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 9s are 18. So 1 upon 19 we got. So what it is asked? What is the ratio of number of teachers to the number of students? So required ratio is 1 upon 19 means 1 is to 19. 1 upon 19 means 1 is to 19. So required ratio is 1 is to 19. Okay. Let's solve question number 2. In a class there are 25 students, means total students are 25 and 10 are boys. In that 10 are boys. What is the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls? Okay, and it is asking the question to find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls, but girls, number of girls it is not given. So we have to find the number of girls. Now how to find the number of girls? See what it is given. See what is given. Given 25 students means in a class there are 25 students. So total students 25. So write here total students 25. Okay. Total students 25. And 10 are boys. In that boys how many are there? Boys 10. Okay. And what it is asked, what is the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls? In total students, see total students are 25 and in that 10 are boys. Then how many number of girls are there? Girls are 15. Total students 25, boys are 10, then girls 15. See, if you will minus from total students, if you will minus boys, number of boys, then you will get the number of girls. So how you will get the number of girls? Number of girls is equal to, what will you do? Total students minus boys. Okay. Number of boys will minus. Okay. Total students how many? 25 students are total students and number of boys are 10. Okay, so if we will minus from total students number of boys, if we will minus, we will get the number of girls. Okay, so number of girls 15. And now what it is asked in the question? What is the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls? Sorry, what we have to find required ratio? Is equal to what is the ratio of number of boys? Okay, number of boys to the number of girls. Number of girls. Okay, now number of boys, how much are there? Number of boys 10, and number of girls 15. It is not given. We have to find the number of girls. How to find the number of girls? Total students it is given, boys it is given, so we can find number of girls from total students. If we subtract the number of boys, we'll get the number of girls. So we have to find the ratio of number of boys is to number of girls. So number of boys 10, so number of girls are 15. Okay, so let's find the ratio. 10 is to 15. Okay, find the ratio. To find the ratio, what we have to do after this? We have to do this in the lowest. Okay, we have to write this ratio in the lowest. Now both the numbers are divisible by 5. Okay, so 10 upon 15. For 10 upon 15 we will divide by 5. 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15. So what we got? 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3 means 2 is to 3. So what is required ratio? Required ratio is 2 is to 3. Required ratio is 2 is to 3. Okay. Question number 3. A ceiling fan weighs 3 kg whereas a handmade fan weighs just 100 gram. Okay. Find the ratio of weight of ceiling fan to the handmade fan. Okay. What we have to find? We have to find the ratio of weight of ceiling fan to handmade fan. So what we have to do here, we have to find the ratio of weight of ceiling fan is to handmade fan. Okay, now ceiling fan is to handmade fan. Now what is the weight of ceiling fan? 3 kg is to handmade fan, weight is 100 gram. Now if you will observe, see, 3 kg is 200 gram. What it is given in the question? Find the ratio of weight of ceiling fan is to handmade fan. We have to find the ratio of ceiling fan is to handmade fan. Now what is the weight of ceiling fan? 3 kg. And what is the weight of handmade fan? 100 gram. Now if you will see, we have to find the ratio of this, but for that we should always keep in mind, in that what it is given, units must be the same. Okay, units must be the same. Now here see, it is given in kilogram and this is in gram, so let's convert kilogram into gram. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to convert kilogram into gram. 3 kg is to 100 gram. We have to find the ratio of 3 kg is to 100 gram. See, 3 kg is to 100 gram. It is given. Okay, we have to find the ratio of this. So 3 kg and 100 gram. So see, here it is given kilogram and here it is given in gram. So what it is given? Units must be the same. So we have to make the same unit. Okay. So kilogram we will convert into gram. So 3 kg means how much gram? So what we got? 3000 gram. So let's find the required ratio. So write here required ratio. What it is given? We have to find the ratio of weight of ceiling fan to handmade fan. Okay. Ceiling fan is to handmade fan. Okay. Handmade fan. Okay. Now ceiling fan. How much it is? 3000 gram. See, we convert kilogram into gram. Units must be the same. So this we got same unit. Here we got 3000 gram and here it is given 100 gram. So ceiling fan, how much it is? 3000 gram. It is given in kilogram. We convert into gram. So 3000 upon. Now handmade fan, how much it is? 100 gram. So write here 100. Okay. So now we got 3000 is to 100. Okay, now let's find the lowest term for this. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. This 0 get cancelled. Now what remains? 30 upon 1. Means what is the ratio? 30 is to 1. So required ratio is? Required ratio is 30 is to 1. Okay.